Hey everyone, we're at the Kaikohe Pioneer Village Museum. I'm looking around at some pioneer stuff. It's quite cool. We're about to go into some of the buildings. So, she's highlighted them all for us. Hey! And some duckies just over there, clicking away. And the big piece of machinery back here. So we'll look around the ones we can.
Page 29, this looks like it was a radar aerial from GNZ.
An aerial, you say? Yeah. Watch for trains there, bunny. Not listening to me at all, as usual. Some pretty gardens.
Can't come in here. So I better go.
Yeah, you better go. You better wait outside. There's stained glass windows. This one. Placed in the church after it moved to Kaikohe in March 1939. Built the church. Made it as a tribute to the early pioneers. And this is like the little Book of Psalms. Such a good Bible. Just the clothes, I guess, saying what I wore. Could you just turn around? I don't think she did. Okay, I'm out. Ooh, awesome. That's just cool. New Zealand's first permanent European settlement. Interesting. Well, here we have the Kaikohe jail built for the Kamo police station. Built in?
1890.
Oh my god.
It's creepy as hell, isn't it? Can you guys see that?
Okay. Out we go. Oh my god! Let's follow the blood trail, shall we? Wait. Ah! Well, imagine if you were,
you
know. A spider? Yeah. Amazing.
Hall and school.
Ooh, a school.
And hall as well.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and the hall. Yeah.
Jesus Christ, mannequins.
Oh my god, I remember having these desks at school.
Yeah.
Or similar, no, not, you know, not with the inkwells, of course.
Yeah, inkwells. But some of them did, they had holes like that.
Yeah, you opened them up like that. Wow.
That's cool.
They had a little fire that they would put on in the winter time, I guess. There were families that attended the school. It's down there. 1903, speaking Maori is banned from the classroom and the playground. That's so sad. They weren't allowed to speak Maori. School rules. Oh! Yeah. You must use your right hand at all times for writing, bunny.
Yeah. Unless you get a ruler.
Ching!
Rules for teachers, 1872. Each teacher will fill lamps. Bring a bucket of water and a scuttle of coal for each day. Make your pens carefully. You make little nibs to the individual taste of pupils. Men teachers may take one evening each week for courting purposes, or two evenings a week if they go to church regularly.
Wow.
Which apparently means that the female teachers can also take a day during the week for courting purposes, or the male would, who's the male courting? Hello?
Exactly.
Women who marry or engage in unseemly conduct will be dismissed. I was going to say dismembered.
Oh my god. Books. Little satchel. That's cool. Looks like a general store. They've got for sale today. Some cool lanterns. Where does the shine come from? Brasso? And of course, Christmas tree. Nice. Register.
poke behind the counter. And there's a livery bike, there's a livery car or whatever, I guess. Make deliveries in.
Not be able to tell if I'm going to do that.
Somebody. So freaking. It's the registrar of birth, deaths and marriages and all that.
I guess the post office part of it. Tricycles today. The dressograph machine.
Ankle printing. Cable exchange.
Monganui, the Maioha cottage, built in 1875. Typical pioneer cottage. Okay, awesome. The bathroom. I mean, I could probably get in there. I would have to live there because I wouldn't be able to get out. Yeah. That's neat.
That is neat. Oh, it flex bags.
Yeah, I know.
Kitty.
Hard to climb the stairs and look at the same time. Oh, bedroom. Kitty's bedroom, I guess. I'm scared I'm going to fall through the floor, god damn it. Oh my god, I feel head moving. Not really, but...
Last
step's a biggie. Somebody slept over here, someone slept over there. Oh, a couple of people sort of slept.
All the family, like, you know, and mum and dad. And
if there was a mum and dad. Well,
oh, mum and dad were downstairs?
Downstairs. That ain't soft. That ain't very soft.
There's a chamber pot under
Yes.
Nice touch.
Alright, let's go then.
Okay, now we're going to go to Harold's solicitor's office in 1912. It was built. Let's go have a look at this. Crutches?
What, a crutch?
Stretcher?
Yeah.
Sometime. Tall straight jacket.
Until early, mid-1970s, they used these kind of things in the ambulances.
Wow.
That's St. John's.
I guess it's doctor, right?
Well, it said 12. It said Harold's solicitor's office. See 1900, but yeah,
it
looks like it's.
With a horrible wheelchair.
I see something on
it. Yeah, not that the straitjacket's not horrible. Some more crutches. Oh god. No. It's awful.
Those are the teeth. Well, I don't know if it's real teeth or meant to be teeth.
Yuck. Nobody is sleeping tonight with the little baby in the corner there. I'll tap the glass or something like that.
Oh god.
Alright. Let's get out of here.
Oh, there's some like, lots of like bits and pieces in there. Snake oil.
Yeah. Pipe of peace and maximum inhaler.
Interesting.
Okay, here we have the outhouse. That's quite cool. But anyway, outhouse which we
jump out at you. Spider.
Spider? Baby seat. Adult seat. Shut that. Go away. This is the funny, I guess.
That is
funny. You can't go in there. But I can sort of see in there the coach house. Oh. Suspiciously new tractor. Did you hear the bird? Let's hide all the people. Right, let's just pass by that. Oh lord, someone. Oh, well, someone, mannequin. I love the mannequins. This is James Purdy, Farrier, and General Blacksmith. Unavailable for live demonstrations at the moment due to a forge undergoing repairs. Oh yeah, there's a forge.
James himself.
Don't you move, buddy, don't move. Hold my camera on. Oh, it goes to there. Pretty though, bird's nest up there. A little bird comes ripping out of it, it'll be tractor. That's neat. And, wow. That's got to be like ancient. After the bread, someone's left behind. Somebody's lunch. These are neat. Trains, buddy, trains. Can you like stop and look before you cross the railway tracks?
My ears aren't painted on.
Might be. You have to stop and look before you run over to the tractors that we are now going to have a look at. Yeah, so do I. Like a little bulldozer tractor. Two-ton. Crank with crank. That's bulldozer, right? Not just a tractor. So is that I guess it's just what we call tractors.
box.
Toki. The most important tool used by the Maori was the toki or adze, which are made of stone. Birds, killing,
digging up,
kura,
gourd, and yam. I think I've got a word for it. Patus
over here.
I like patus. Bash you.
You
what? Is that what you bash your head in with?
Yeah.
And a tool for weeding kura.
Kiri or kahiru? Kumite, which is a food bowl. Oh, a big food bowl. I suppose you had to feed a lot of people. You feed like the whole whole tribe, not just your family, you know? On this wall is the original small pane windows, which date from 1862. On sailing ship day, small panes travelled with less breakages. That's interesting. Well, probably true.
Yeah.
There is a... all the bayonets and things. Somersetshire officer's uniform. There's a Northern War, of course. I suspect this is what this is about. A sword and a scabbard. The origins of the war. New Zealand wars began fighting between Ngapuhi and government troops at Russell in the Bay of Islands. Anihike, this of course cut down the flagstaff at Russell 4 times to make his point. The Ngapuhi hapu, led by Tamati Nene, sided with the British. Interesting.
Interesting.
So it was 1845 to 1846. There's some cannonballs. Cannonballs were found on the site where the battle was fought. So they'd like dig them up out of the ground.
Ooh.
What is it called too? Here's where the actual courthouse is. Well, I mean, this is the actual courthouse, but... I'm just going to stand over here. I guess... Oh, this is... or in here to give you evidence. Probably.
Go.
I swear on my life. Anything.
I didn't do it.
Yeah, I did. I did it. Because it would probably be I did it.
Oh dear.
Mr. Judge, jury, person that sits down there.
Executioner.
Yeah. And get out of here. It's scaring me.
Stout-legged mower.
There's something wrong with that. What is it? Well, it looks like an egg with legs and a beak.
Oh, I didn't even see it until you said it's too big.
There's our kiwi.
Kiwi.
Yeah. I know kiwis do like humongous eggs for them.
That is that about that big.
Huge. Well, for the size of the bird.
Yeah.
Here. No, probably not. Oh, I better not go up there. I'll want to, but hey.
Who's that, Queen? Is that Queen Victoria?
Yeah.